And just like that, we are back. Welcome to the Tennessee Jamboree, the first time ever. You know who I am. I needn't say my name. Let's go over your card for this evening. Now, there's a match we cannot show you as it is too hardcore for the Jamboree. We're going to give you a sneak peek of the Underground Championship match between the Chosen One, Jared Black, and No Gimmicks Needed Chance Sullivan. A match we frankly can't show you because it's too violent for the Jamboree. Also coming up here, we have the crowning of the first Southern champion, Joe Anderson and Buzzsaw Billy. Should be one hell of a matchup. Let's hope nothing goes wrong. Sure to be a great matchup between these two. Two of our best technicians, a powerhouse, and a risk taker. This is going to be a great match. And in our main event, folks, who will answer the open challenge of the world champion? CJ will defend his title in an anonymous open challenge. This is going to be one hell of a show. Let's go to your sneak peek real quick. Now, for this match here, we do not know who won. It was filmed a few days before the actual shoot, but you see Jared Black and Chance Sullivan there fighting near these canoes. Now, who these canoes belong to, no one knows, but they look pretty expensive. As you can see here, Sullivan knocks the yellow canoe over. That's a pain in the ass for the cleanup crew. That much is for sure. Now, you see Jared Black dragging Chance Sullivan over to what looks to be a wheelbarrow area as he takes this, looks to be a Spider-Man crucifix and pops the motherfucker right there. Now, Black kept wailing on him. Sullivan was screaming out in just pure agony as Black is now going to go to the wheelbarrow here. Now, I can't tell who wins this match. We won't know until Monday night. But the tenacity within these two is so good. As you can see, the Underground title there being used as a weapon by the Chosen One. And now he's in a wheelbarrow. Wait a minute. Folks, we have to interrupt the sneak peek. We are getting a very strange report. I'm getting a report in my ear from Logan Price. Apparently, Joe Anderson was found unconscious in his home earlier this morning, and Buzzsaw Billy called. He cannot make it because of a sugar in his gas tank and a slashed tires. We have to go to an impromptu match per Logan Price. I'm not sure what's going on here. Well, here's Pogo. We've not seen Pogo in months, but I'm still not sure what's going on here. This was supposed to be Buzzsaw Billy and Joe Anderson, but it seems someone must have taken them out as this strange-looking clown. What is going on here? It's Sunday night one, folks, but the pandemonium is already getting off to a big start as this strange, twisted, drug addict clown. And you hear the mute. I know this music. This is interesting. One of the names we announced for the Tennessee Jamboree tomorrow. He's here on night one. He was not supposed to be here until the Jamboree. Our resident detective, Captain Law, is in the building here, folks. And it seems he might have cashed in on this opportunity because he has a chance to make history. The first Southern champion will be crowned this evening, and we're about to see it between Captain Law and Pogo.
Too sweet!
Too sweet for the big guy upstairs. Law taking his time for the entrance. It's not like we have a time limit here, but we're going to go with it. Making his way to the ring in this dark arena, it seems. Someone might have cut the power besides a floodlight. I don't know. This is mighty close, but don't you believe, maybe, folks, this could be the work of CJ's accomplice, his brother, the mysterious DL. He said he was on his way. We're not sure if he's here or not. Everybody in the crew has been accounted for. The doors are locked. What a strange and circumstance this is. We're now going to get into the contest here. Pogo and Captain Law. Not exactly Buzzsaw and Anderson, but this should work. Referee. Very strange referee. This is a really... Pogo attacks him now. Bell is rung. And this contest is underway. A big claw This is a... What is going on here? I don't mean to harp on these two. They didn't know any better, but this was supposed to be between two of, the most, toughest and decorated UWA stars, but it turned out to be this clown pogo and a decorated champion from outside of UWA in Captain Law. Strange things happen here, folks. You never know what could happen in the bank just like this. Dick twist. He twists the nose instead. What? Into the corner is Law. Both men are in their corners now. Big splash from Captain Law. Big bulldog. Going for the cover. Yes, the leg is hooked. One, two, no. Not at all.
Boo!
Crowd is not happy about this. I know they wanted Buzzsaw and Joe Anderson. Big claw now by this clown. I don't know where he even comes from, folks, but he's kind of weird. It's kind of
suck. These guys suck.
Now,
these guys suck. These
the clown
guys
puts
suck.
On a chokehold.
These guys suck. These guys suck. These guys suck. Stupid ass clown.
Crowd is chanting
stupid
against the clown. Stupid ass clown, I kind of agree, as Captain Law now with the haymakers on Pogo. Irish whip. Big lariat from Captain Law. Law is a former 7-time CBW critical heavyweight champion. Truly an accolade that cannot go unmentioned. Among other various titles that he has held, but tonight he's the opportunity to be crowned the first UWA Southern heavyweight champion. That is an honor that nobody can take away from him. Headlock now applied. This referee is looking just absolutely stunning. Dummy thick is this referee here.
This ref sucks.
We're having fun here.
This ref sucks.
As now, Pogo is now in the fetal position. What the hell? Okay. I don't mean to question Logan Price, but why did he pick these two? Law, I can understand. He's an accomplished competitor. Why is he beating up the ref?
Oh, hi, Mr. Referee. How you doing?
Are these two drunk?
You just hit the referee.
The choke now from the killer clown. What is this? Can we get some order here? Again, I don't mean to take away from this match, but this was supposed to be between the Grim Reaper and the Wheel Buzzsaw Billy. The real Buzzsaw Billy. Not a clown and Captain Law. Though Law is a horrible competitor, another big clothesline sends Pogo down. He's now getting his elbow ready for something. I'm not sure what he's going to do with that elbow. I'm going to go for the choke slam position. Has him in a choke. Gets him up. What's he going to set up here for? Could barely get the clown up, but then he gets him down. He's going to fold him for some kind of cover. One, two, and three. Just like that, your first Southern champion is Captain Law, but you have to wonder. He has to thank his lucky stars. Because of somebody else's actions, he has become the Southern heavyweight champion. But you have to feel bad for Buzzsaw Billy and Joe Anderson. This is their time, their moment to wrestle, their moment to shine. And it's been taken away, we can only presume, the mysterious DL. But I guess congratulations to Captain Law for his victory. It wasn't exactly hard fought, because the clown is a clown, folks. He is not a serious wrestler. He did put up a good fight with the chokeholds, but Captain Law is your first Southern heavyweight champion that can be taken away from him. Celebrating. Congratulations to him, but you have to wonder. This April, folks, is Destiny. Look out for that. As we go into the main event, who will answer the open challenge of the heavyweight champion? CJ is having the floor open. Who will accept the open challenge? It could be anyone, ladies and gentlemen. But here we go. As you hear the music of the world champion, here in this new setup here, and to wonder how he feels after decimating Buzzsaw Billy a few weeks ago. He comes out now. Look at that belt. There he is. The man has been undefeated ever since his arrival. Is in the arena, sporting new gold and Logan. We're getting these referees. Who is that? Okay, I guess that's the referee. Even CJ is a mite confused here. He's just grunting. Sounds like my ex, to be honest with you. As now they shake hands, CJ is now going to await the open challenge. Who is it? Oh! No! No, there's no way! Even CJ. Folks, that is the music of the owner of UWA, Logan Price. Wait, just he can't be here. He can't be here. He kind of teased it. Music is still playing. Hey, wait a minute. There he is.
CJ, up here. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm not there. I know you were expecting me to be there, to actually show up, to face you, to confront you, to let out my anger on you. I'm sorry, sweetheart. But I had to do what I had to do to make you think that you were actually worth my time. But I do have some good news in this situation, CJ. Someone did contact me and asked me if he could compete on my behalf. And I said, go for it. The more people we have to fix this CJ problem, the better. CJ, good luck.
Well, it said he found the challenger. Who's it gonna be? Well, CJ knows that music apparently. He knows that music really well. We don't know that music. That could be anybody. Now, let's see here. Who could this be? One, you know it, it's Jared Black. How'd he get the Underground title? What the hell? I think he stole that belt from somebody. We don't know the results of the match. It's gonna be uploaded later. I mean, he could have won it, but okay, who knows? But there's just something like more important going on here. CJ looks like he's seen a ghost in the form of his, I guess his mentor, the chosen one, Jared Black.
Cut the music!
He's saying to cut the music. Jesus Christ, please spare my ears. What's he got to say?
I do. I got a present for you. Come on, take it. CJ.
And CJ just yeets the shirt. We didn't get to see what was on that shirt, but he just yeeted like it was no tomorrow. I guess the open challenge is mentor against student. Jared Black against CJ for the world title. That's a sentence I never thought I would hear myself say. Now, I'm willing to bet that everybody... Oh, the lights are on. I'm willing to bet that everybody, the odds-on favorite here is CJ. The bell is rung, but don't discount Jared Black. He's a devious mind who knows his wrestling. If anything, okay, getting close to each other. Oh my God! Big shoves from the champion.
Where the fuck did you go?
I cannot believe.
Language, my God. Kids watching.
Oh my God!
pushes him. Oh my god! Just stomping on him, my gosh! Big elbow drops, and he's not just saying little words, he's talking full sentences here. He's getting more talkative by the month as he stomps on Jared Black. CJ is a man possessed here. Oh my, just crushes the arm. Classic CJ maneuvers here. Whoever hired this ref, I'm sure Logan Price didn't do his research. As now, CJ. Oh my god, stomping on it. There's not really much I can really say. Because, you know, this is a personal matter. Super kick in the gut. Big kick. It's clear that something is wrong here. There's an energy in CJ. Bulldog that we've not quite seen before. There's an energy here that is unmatched, quite frankly. As CJ, I think he's crying. He's crying. But Jared Black's trying to take the opportunity now to get some shots in on him. I told you, don't discount Jared Black. Jared Black in the corner. No! Big boot. Big boot here. Big boot. More big boots. It's like a storm of big boots. Oh my god! He just keeps stomping on the ankle. I gotta be honest with you folks, this show has felt really bizarre. It almost feels like someone, I'm willing to bet it's DL, but whoever's working for CJ here, they must have sunk their claws in this production somehow. This is the most bizarre feeling show I've called in the history of UWA, as now Black is on the outside and CJ on the in. This is nonsense. Oh my god! Clothesline! He's trying just to. I think CJ is just trying to kill him. As now. Crossface! Crossface here. Jared probably should just tap. Because there's really no way this can go any kind of way besides CJ's. I'm sorry to say it. But there's something a little bit fishy about all of this. Oh no! I'm just beginning to suspect we need to invest in some more, you know, security or something. I don't know. As now, CJ is in total control. I do have to remind you, everyone, this is only night one. Tomorrow is the Tennessee Jamboree match. 19 men will enter the Tennessee Jamboree. Oh, my God. I'm interrupted here. But 19 men will enter the Tennessee Jamboree match. One comes out the winner. One goes on to face that man in the ring there, CJ, for the world title in the main event of our biggest event of all time, Final Destination. Because now, clearly, this is a case right here of... Jared's back up, though. Jared's back up. Super kick to the gut. Jared Black actually has some kind of control. But CJ's caught it. Trips him down. This is just... Again, there's something strange going on here. But I think CJ's going to tune up for it. I think he's calling for the K&K. Time and time again, we've seen the K&K. Wait, Jared Black's trying to talk him down. I'm not sure it's going to work. Just talking. No, a kick to the gut. K&K! Jared flops down. All right. Now I think it. No! Oh no! Shape shifter. And that is it. That's it. We see just domination from the champion. Music begins to play. This is a pre-tape, by the way. I thought I should mention. This has got to be the most odd UWA event that I have called in the brief history of this company. Not sure what's going on. Okay, there goes the referee. Both men are at a standstill. CJ has the world championship. He has that shirt. He has the shirt. What's the shirt? We didn't see it earlier. The Midwest Mafia. That's a group with so much history. It seems it's been reformed. What does this mean? What's gonna happen tomorrow? What's gonna happen tomorrow? I really don't know what's gonna happen.